So we have those students. We have special ed students. And special ed students, depending on the disability, we have students here who, most of the students here use some cognitive delay. And so I think it's just the intent is, students with special disabilities, they need education year-round. And so the government provides it.
And do they work with all of them together?
No, there's different categories, different ages. We have some students who are autistic. We have some students that have some mental retardation. We have students learning disability. So you'll see some of the students.
Are the teachers prepared to work with them?
Yes.
Yeah.
And all the teachers that you'll see, most of them are from other schools during the school year. So we're hosting a lot of foreigners.
Do you have to supervise the teachers that are here in summer school too? You did the same process, observe them and...
No.
No?
No observation during the summer.
Okay.
Okay, but the students with special abilities, they stay together, right?
It's based on age and the disability. So we have like 6 or 7 classrooms with the special education students, because they're classified by disability and by age. You know, you don't want someone who's 14 years old next to someone who's 5.
Okay, but what I'm asking is, a student with special disabilities, he can't stay with a regular class?
Depending on their disability.
Okay.
We try to, it's called least restrictive environment. So we try to maximize the amount of time a student is with the general education.
Let's
that's during the school year.
Try to understand. This is a state school.
City.
Local.
Yeah, it's a local.
Okay.
School.
So, who provides the payments? Is Chicago or Illinois? Chicago.
Chicago. Well, both. I mean, the way the funding works in this, actually, it's local property taxes, it's state taxes, and federal government. We get money from all three.
Okay.
And that's because of the low income. The amount of students with low income.
Mm-hmm.
You have some very, very wealthy schools, and the parents throw money to make it even better. Well, my parents can't do that. And that's why the federal government gives us money. So we get about $1 million a year in federal and state assistance. And so it's kind of the equalizer. And that's why we have extra teachers and a lot of computers, laptops, iPads, smartboards. So I used to do a lot of home visits, and the homes are very, very simple. Some of the students, they move a lot. So they have a mattress on the floor, a cardboard box with a TV on it, and it's all designed for easy transportation. And so when they come to here, I want them to have a beautiful school to come to. Mm-hmm. So I try to just come to the front or the back.
I think it was the main entrance door.
Did you see the garden?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. So those are all really nice touches.
Mm-hmm.
A lot of people comment on how pretty the school is. They're cleaning now, but we can go up to the gymnasium and I can show you that.
The transportation is free for the students?
Yes.
Yes?
For the special ed students. Since we are a neighborhood school, we don't offer, they should be able to walk here,
okay,
unless they're special ed.
And as a principal, how long are you going to stay as a principal here? How long can you stay? All the time?
Yeah.
If you obey all the criteria that they want, okay.
As long as the school keeps improving,
okay.
The parents, the six parents, and there's six parents because they have the most investment.
Oh, okay.
The teachers have an investment. The community has an investment. Because if this is a good school, the values of the homes will go up.
Okay.
So that's why they created this council, because everybody has a stake.
Okay.
And so as long as I keep them happy, I can stay here. And so, once a month, we just met last night actually. Because they gave us, the council is in charge of three things. Me, my evaluation, and if it's a new principal, my selection. They're in charge of, they approve the money. How do we distribute the money? So the government gave us extra money last week. So I had to tell them, well, this is what I'd like to spend the money on. Can I have your blessing?
Okay.
And so they approve it. And I get the teachers involved. So I use Google Docs. Are you familiar with Google?
Okay. Yeah.
So, you know, I send an email out, I tell them to look at this document, this is how I like to spend the money, what are your thoughts? I'm a bit of a politician too. And so, you know, you want people to follow you, you have to work with people. You know, you grow a garden with water, not with, you know, hate. So it's, in this job, I swallow a lot of aggravation. So, yeah, there's things I want to say, but I can't.
Okay.
Because, you know, it's frustrating. So, there's 55 teachers here, and another 10 teacher aides. Then there's the lunch people, the custodians that clean. Bus monitors, you know, so there's about 90 people that I supervise.
Mm-hmm.
And the good thing is, 15 do their jobs. But, you know, there's that 15 that I have to manage.
Yeah, it's the same as you. We have these kind of problems too.
Yeah. Well, it's human nature.
Yeah.
I was going to ask, what's the average salary for a CPS instructor? Does it vary by school? Do you get to set the range? And how many hours
They're moving towards merit pay.
Okay.
Right now, a starting teacher might make $40,000 a year.
$40,000 a year.
50. I think it's between 40 and 50.
40.
Is it based on experience?
A year.
That's first year.
Yes.
That's your first year. No experience.
It might be even closer to 50. I don't control the salary, so I don't know.
And how many classes do they teach? What's an average teaching load or responsibilities?
It's not based on classes. It's based on 8:15 in the morning to 3:15 in the afternoon.
Okay.
3:15.
And they get 1 hour of preparation time and a 45-minute lunch.
Sir, are specific classrooms for each subject? A classroom for math, a classroom for Portuguese, a classroom
So students in preschool through sixth grade stay with the one teacher. The one teacher teaches everything. Seventh and eighth grade, they switch. So we do have a specific teacher for each of those subjects.
And is it a specific room?
Yes, it changes room. Well, it's based on the teacher, where the teacher is. They go to the teacher.
They go to?
Yes.
It's different from Brazil.
There's a range.
Brazil.
It could be as little as 22 students.
Some of them.
And as many as 32 students.
It's
some grades it goes a lot, some grades it goes a little.
Is there a maximum amount that you're